G'day, g'day. Welcome back. Welcome to the living room. And thanks for joining me on the channel. If you're brand new here, hit that subscribe button, give the video a like, and why don't we just get stuck into having a chat about my long-term opinion. I'm not going to give it a review. I like doing opinions because it is only my personal opinion about the Shoei GT Air 2 with the Sena. I've got the SRL2 all fully installed. And of course, as most of you know, I hadn't ridden for 16 years, got back on a bike at the end of 2019, and really excited about that, was quite keen to get into it. The first helmet I bought was the Bell MX9 Adventure helmet, which is great because the full intention is to go down the adventure bike path. More about that a little bit later. And I wasn't really getting a lot of love out of that helmet, so I looked at investing and getting something a little more road touring style, and I really wanted something with the integrated Bluetooth headset. So, Shoei's GT Air 2. When it finally arrived, I got all the gear all together, installed it all. Very, very easy to install. This thing is so easy to pull apart and then again put back together, and there's plenty of room. Of course, if you want full rundowns on how to install stuff, there's heaps of videos on YouTube. But I ended up spending about 15 minutes getting all the equipment geared up into the helmet, paired it up with the phone. I had the iPhone at the time, and away we went. So after, I think I've had this about a year now, maybe a little bit more, and I've loved it. I've got a couple of gripes, but a lot of love. It's been a great helmet. Kind of regret going black because our summers here, they get pretty toasty, and you certainly feel that with the kind of heat. But you do have these two air vents here. Now, these two vents, top one makes quite a lot of noise, funnily enough. It is quite a noisy helmet, and I actually do wear earplugs for 90% of the time, especially if I'm doing long rides. My hearing's bad as it is after my flying career, so let's not make it any worse. So earplugs are in, and when this vent's open, stacks of air over the top of the head, which is brilliant, but it does make a bit of noise. The chin vent, I haven't found overly impressive. It does work, but probably could work a little bit better. That's not really one of the gripes. I mean, this is okay. I can deal with that. One of my big gripes is the way this locks. Now, I did mention this in one of the videos, and one of the lads made a comment about adjusting these. So ever since making adjustments to the screws here, it does lock down a lot better. But I did find it was very hard to, even now, you really got to use your palm to get that thing locked, and then it pops up pretty easy. So that's been one of the only gripes, other than the fact that it's kind of a little bit noisy as well. But once that lid's down, it's pretty good. I have ridden in some seriously dodgy weather and some big rain, and with that rain did come some leaks. So, you know, my next helmet, which will be an adventure helmet, again, more on that later, my next helmet, I will be looking at something that's got a bit of a better seal to stop that rain coming in. I am an everyday rider. The GS is my main go-to bike or my vehicle. So if I need to get around like I am today, I'm going to be throwing a leg over the GS. Today's a brilliant day, but if it was raining again, I do know that I'm going to get a bit of a dribble coming through the top of the visor. That's all right, though. I can deal with that. The added pin lock. Now, this has been a lifesaver. Cold mornings, first thing in the morning going to work, it does fog up. The only problem is sometimes these little notches for the pin lock, yeah, they do move. And I don't know that they've moved until it starts fogging up kind of, you know, up here through sections of the pin lock. Can get away with that. That's actually pretty good. Now, any helmet that I buy, must have. This is a must have. And let me just throw this on. Okay, it's got to have the tinted visor. I hate riding around with a fully tinted visor because you just never know when you're going to get caught in the evening. And I really don't like having to change out a visor all the time. So the inner sun visor, this thing, seriously, ducks nuts. Again, fogs up a lot. And you saw one of the shorts I did with the head and shoulders. Doesn't work. Doesn't work at all. Forget that. Who was it? It was Fortnite. Ryan. He's the one. He suggested it. Well, sorry, Ryan. Even now, I'm fogging up. Fogging up like anything. Ugh. So, yeah. For a helmet that's worth its weight in gold if you're looking at around a grand Australian. This is actually a spot-on helmet if you want the integrated Bluetooth. Very easy to use, easy to connect to your phone. I've got a Pixel 5 now, got away from the iPhone, and it works a treat with a Pixel 5. With my big dry rider gloves, can still operate this quite effectively. It is very loud, so that when I do have the earplugs in here, I can still hear quite well through the speakers. I wouldn't mind considering upgrading to the higher spec speakers if I can, but that'll be, you know, that'll be something else for another day. So all up with a Shoei GT Air 2 with a Sena SRL 2. Look, I give this a good solid 7 out of 10. This has been a brilliant helmet. It is very, very comfortable. It was easy to get one of these Ride Tech kind of, what's it called, a Canadian made GoPro mount. So I've got the GoPro there. It originally had it around the side there, and that was great. But, you know, it was just better having it on the chin. So yeah, that's still there. Brilliant helmet. Do love it. Couple of small gripes, but you can live with that kind of stuff. If you're chasing a helmet, and of course I'm not sponsored by Shoei or anyone else, God, wouldn't that be great? Yeah, chasing a helmet and you're considering the Shoei GT Air 2, I give it a thumbs up. I reckon you'll love it. Fits nice and snug. I'm a medium, so you know, I've got a very strangely shaped bollard, and this fits me really well. The old helmets that I used to run with, used to have a Suomi back in the day, that fit like a real treat, and the Bell MX9 adventure helmet that I had for 7 or 8 months, that fit really well as well. This is brilliant. This is a really nice lid. My next helmet, so going down the adventure path, and there'll be another video on changes with the channel coming up, looking at another adventure helmet. We'll figure that out later on. Hopefully something that's got the integrated Bluetooth again, because I don't like having this big bulky thing out the side. Well, I don't like the idea of it. So yeah, we'll see how we go. As for this, if you're looking at it, if you're considering it, yeah, I give it a thumbs up. If you've got any questions, if I haven't covered anything, leave a comment down below. Give us a like for the video. I'm going to go for a ride. It's a cracking day outside. We're in the midst of COVID, a really harsh lockdown. We're getting over 1,000 active cases every day. But I've got to go and inspect the new house. Speaking of new houses, see, now I'm just going to dribble crap for a little bit. Been living in this place for the last 4 years, nearly 5 years. We're building a house and we're getting the hell out of here. So it's pretty bare, pretty good. It's been all right, but we're going to be happy to get out. Anyhow, that's for another story. I'm going to get out of here. There you go. 7 out of 10 for the Shoei GT Air 2. Enjoy your day. Ride safe if you're heading out. Thanks for sticking around and we'll chat again soon. Cheers.